Hi, I'm Tracy Shields, a biomedical librarian at the NIH Library, and today I'll be discussing in five different parts, searching the literature. In this first part, we're going to talk about the value of having a comprehensive literature search. In this section, we're going to learn about the importance of the literature search, when to search, how you develop your search process, and the difference between a search versus a review. In 2001, there was a study done at Johns Hopkins University where a healthy human volunteer died after giving the study drug by inhalation. During the investigation, it was found that while they had done a standard PubMed search and had looked at current edition of textbooks about the particular drug, they didn't find a potential toxicity that was related to the volunteer's death because of not going back far enough in the literature. So a literature search is very important, not only for the context of your research, but for safety measures too. So why do we search the literature? Well, it really reveals gaps in knowledge and exposes the evidence that is currently there, but it also avoids duplication of effort and shows where there are areas of consensus and debate within the research areas and may inform your methodology as well. It helps identify the other researchers in the field and some future directions for research, but it also ensures the ethical and professional standards needed to do clinical research in humans. So when do you do the search? Well, obviously, before things start, when you're formulating your research question, is a good place to start. But also, just at the beginning of your research, to revisit anything you might have missed in that initial search. You can search within the project itself to keep up on the literature as it develops over time. And when you finish, as you get ready to disseminate or publish, hopefully, your research. And then even after your research is done, you may want to continue to search the literature to track the work that you've done and see how it's impacted the literature moving forward. So what's the process of searching the literature? Well, you need to define your research question, but then additionally, you need to read the background material. You need to formulate your search strategies. You need to decide which databases you want to search in. Do the search, review the results that you find, retrieve and then read the articles that you find most relevant. And during this whole process, you need to document your results. And you may do this process over and over and over. It's an iterative process and requires multiple steps. And you may go back and forth within this process as needed, depending on what you come across and what your research needs are. So let's talk a little bit about a search versus a review. The literature search itself, as I said, identifies the articles on the topic for your research, and it could be simple or complex, and you may need to cover more than just your actual research topic if you're needing background information or having an overall idea of the field. Ideally, your search should be comprehensive and systematic, but that's not the same as something that you often hear as a systematic review. That's a different animal entirely. The literature review then takes what you have found by the search and summarizes and synthesizes it into something that makes sense. This is often the responsibility of the principal investigator or your subject matter expert for the study itself. And there can be different types of reviews based on the methodology. As I mentioned before, the systematic review has a very specific methodology that it follows, or you could have something that's more of a narrative review that is a simpler process and is comprehensive, but doesn't require as many steps or a specific methodology. The literature search is ideally more than you just Google this, and is something that is documented over time. It usually requires that you search in multiple places with multiple searches, and this will, what you choose to search may depend on your topic or your field of study. It also reveals where you may publish later based on the articles you come across and the journals you see them published in based on your topic. The literature review itself helps develop this overall 35,000 foot view of the literature and will help explain and justify your research to others. And it provides a foundation for your research protocol in that you may, based on methodologies, do a particular type of study, and your literature review will justify that for you. And it can also help with your final dissemination of your article, because if you do this literature review right, you will have your background and discussion already done. So in summary, literature searches are a critical, fundamental step in any research project, and it serves multiple purposes and is the foundation of your research. And your literature search is not the same as literature review, so you need to know the difference. So some questions to consider: what are some consequences of an inadequate literature search? When and how often should you do searches in support of your clinical research? Thank you for listening.